Light probes are an effective solution for plausible indirect lighting in interactive applications and commodity hardware. Unfortunately, placing the probes is usually performed either by an error-prone manual procedure or through automated solutions that don't consider the light distribution in the scene. We propose a simple and generic algorithm to address these problems. Our approach aims at preserving the probes that contribute to any luminance transitions or chrominance variations in the scene. Our method operates in two stages, setup and simplification. First, a large number of probes is placed in the scene according to a user-selected space-filling strategy. Then, the probes are spatially connected to form a graph, and their radiance field is computed. Next, a number of evaluation points is also placed in the scene to sample the cast light field. Finally, the incident energy for each evaluation point is computed by sampling its nearest probes, and then it is stored as a reference to guide the next step. Then, the simplification stage starts by removing a light probe from the graph and recomputing the graph connections. Given this new graph, the new radiance field is computed and compared to the reference. This probe is then placed back, and the method continues until it has checked all probes in the graph. In the end, the probe with the least error is removed, and the graph connectivity is restructured. This whole process is repeated until any of the terminating conditions that are presented next are met. We use two user-friendly stopping conditions. First, the requested light probe number is reached, and second, the maximum percentage error is reached. To measure the error, we compute the incident energy at each evaluation point. However, RGB does not provide a meaningful representation for illumination. So, we convert radiance to a luminance-chrominance representation and use these as criteria for more perceptually meaningful measurements. Now, let's see some results of our method. A preliminary version of a Unity prototype, as well as the source code of our method, is available on our GitHub page. Thank you for watching our video.